Welcome to Arlington Public News. I'm Carla Dorado.
And I'm Paul Whirlin. Thanks for joining us. In this edition of APN, after all the campaigning, debating, and analysis, you went to the polls and made your voice heard. We'll have key results from Election Day 2018 and what the final tally means for the future.
And another Arlington shop closes its doors for good. This one came with little or no warning.
And they seem to be everywhere. Arlington's ubiquitous Lime bikes. How are Arlingtonians warming up to this new and colorful mode of transport? We'll tell you that and more next. Stay with us. Arlington police are investigating a series of house break-ins, nearly a dozen so far since the month of September.
And one is caught on a video just released by the Arlington PD. Police say the break-ins have occurred in the early evening hours from 4:30 to 8 p.m. What you're seeing occurred recently on Moulton Road. A male suspect is seen on the video using a flashlight to search the house. Police say the burglar is 6'1" tall, thin build, and has a light complexion. He is seen on this video wearing what appears to be a hoodie, long pants, gloves, and sneakers. Authorities say all homes targeted are situated on street corners or near a corner. And items taken include jewelry, cash, electronic equipment, camera equipment, and anyone with information on this recent rash of break-ins is asked to call Arlington Police at 781-316-3910.
In tonight's snapshot, a plan to get students doing better on the statewide MCAS exam. Brenda Mahoney joins us now in the studio.
Yeah, Carla, Paul, thank you. Students are just getting their individual MCAS test scores, good or bad. But on the whole, Arlington schools are looking to boost student achievement. The second year results of the updated Massachusetts Comprehensive Assessment System, known as MCAS 2.0, show some gains, but also some dips. Assistant Superintendent Roderick McNeil told the school committee at their October 25th meeting that he has concerns with some grade levels that aren't increasing their scores compared to the state. He also wants to look more closely at achievement gaps between all students and those in subgroups based on high needs, race, ethnicity, gender, and an economic disadvantage.
We need to figure out what are those barriers that are preventing those students from achieving equally or exceeding those students that are in the all student category, and we need to focus on how we can raise those students' achievement. Would I say that does the test represent the standards that they're presenting to us? Yes. I think it's incumbent upon districts to figure out what the standards are and figure out how you make those adjustments in the curriculum and instruction.
Assistant Superintendent McNeil says new curriculum is being implemented district-wide, such as a new reading program that he expects will raise district scores. The link to the full presentation on MCAS scores can be found on the Arlington Public Schools website. Paul?
After months of political TV ads, scores of campaign signs, and a deluge of political ranting on social media, it was time to go to the polls and vote. Election Day 2018 is now one for the history books, but it definitely made its mark in some key races and statewide ballot questions. Several polling places in Arlington, like Town Hall and the Thompson School, reported a steady stream of voters and very high turnouts, especially during the morning and afternoon rush hours. According to unofficial election results from town leaders, nearly 80% of Arlington's registered voters went to the polls in the rain on Tuesday. They told APN Election Day is all about participation in community and civic life.
I really feel that people should take an interest in what's happening further beyond the bubble that they're living in, that this affects, you know, this is a chain reaction to everything that's going on in the whole country.
Personally, I think that people who don't vote are in their own way voting. I wish it wasn't the case that more people would engage and be part of the process, but I understand when people don't.
Governor Charlie Baker and Senator Elizabeth Warren both retain their seats for another term. Democrat incumbent Catherine Clark also won in the 5th Congressional District.
Election officials say statewide ballot questions clearly lured voters out of their homes and to the polls. One of the most divisive and expensive campaigns was over question number one, a ballot initiative that had nurses statewide at odds. The initiative proposed to set limits on the number of patients nurses can be assigned at any given time. Supporters said statewide nurse-to-patient ratios were necessary for the safety of patients and the welfare of nurses. Opponents contended that the cost of hiring more nurses to adhere to the state limits could force smaller medical facilities to close. In the end, Massachusetts voters firmly rejected the measure. APN caught up with the president of the Massachusetts Nurses Association, who admits it was a long, hard-fought campaign.
Unfortunately, it does have nurses divided, but I'm one of the nurses that helped write the ballot question. I'm a nurse that's been at the bedside for my entire career of over 40 years, taking care of patients. We have been identifying this as a problem in the hospitals for over 20 years. As we started to see more and more for-profits coming into the Commonwealth, what we saw was an erosion of nursing care at the bedside of patients. So it's the nurses that take care of the patients that are out there fighting for this. It was the nurses that care for the patients that wrote this ballot question, and we're the nurses that not only funded it, but are out here making sure that everyone understands how important it is for their safety in the hospital.
Ms. Kelly Williams tells APN she will fight hard in her capacity to make sure patients are always priority one.
Massachusetts voters also passed question three, upholding a two-year state law protecting transgender people in public accommodations. That 2016 law allows people to use locker rooms, restrooms, and other similar facilities corresponding with the gender with which they identify, not with their assigned sex at birth. You can get all of your up-to-the-minute election results by clicking on arlingtonma.gov.
The ovens are cold at the Arlington Center Papageno's on Mass Ave. This after the pizza chain announced this week it was closing nearly 100 pizza shops across New England. One is in Arlington. It's lights out at the Papageno's on 457 Mass Ave location, where a sign in the storefront says it all. Papageno says this is part of its effort to complete a proposed sale to Wind Church Capital Portfolio Company. In a statement, Papageno said the mass closings would bolster the pizza chain's financial picture, allowing the pizza chain to upgrade nearly 150 company-owned restaurants in Massachusetts, New Hampshire, Connecticut, and Rhode Island. There are reports this week mass closing came as a shock to employees and vendors alike, who claim they didn't know what had happened until they found the doors to the pizza shops locked.
If you've been in Arlington for more than 5 minutes, you've likely seen those bright green bicycles sitting idle near Town Hall, East Arlington, or maybe the Minuteman Bikeway. According to town officials, they don't sit idle for too long. They are the e-assist bikes, part of the Dockless Bike Share pilot program in Arlington. And according to town officials, in the course of this program, these Lime bikes have already traveled the distance that would cover more than two round trips from Arlington to London. Here's APN's Jeff Barnd.
Motor down any Arlington Avenue, and chances are good you'll see northeastern colors of gold, yellow, red, and green in the trees. And you may also see a few tropical colors appearing out of place this time of year.
Some people, you know, may like the aesthetics of it. Some people may really dislike the aesthetics of it. I think it's kind of either you like them or not in that sense.
But in just about every sense, the Dockless Lime bikes are thus far peddling impressive numbers. Arlington's senior transportation planner says Lime bike users have taken more than 15,000 rides on the Dockless bike share system since their summer debut. That averages roughly 1,100 rides per week since the end of August, more than seven times the number of rides recorded in July when the Dockless bike share pilot was launched.
It's been going very well. People have been taking about 3,000, a little more than 3,000 trips per month over the last 4 months that it's been active. So it's been very successful.
Among the top locations for unlocking and parking these bicycles are along the Mass Avenue, Broadway, and Minuteman Bikeway corridors. These bicycles allow users to use a mobile app to find and then rent their ride. Just a few seconds to unlock their bike with a simple QR code, and its kickstand's up.
Town officials say when this pilot program began, they were receiving some complaints about these Dockless bikes being left in front of homes and cluttering up sidewalks and also street corners. But as the months progressed, Amstutz says those complaints have lessened ever since the bike riders are now realizing where there are pickup and drop-off zones that are designated. And also residents are becoming quite used to this bike being part of their community, a very unique mode of transportation that has proven to become quite popular.
if people have concerns about their locations or where they are dropping them, they can report that directly to LimeBike or to Lime. But directly to me or to the planning department, haven't heard a lot lately.
Town officials say it's all part of a process for Arlingtonians to warm up to this pilot program, even during the winter months, when the number of these neon green two-wheelers is expected to dwindle.
There'll be reduced numbers during the winter because of that, but I think once we get back into spring and summer again, we'll see them jump up again.
In fact, Amstutz says, if the demand remains strong, Arlington could soon be outfitted with as many as 300 Lime bikes standing by, waiting for the next ride. I'm Jeff Barnd, Arlington Public News.
Town leaders say the typical ride on a Lime bike takes about 10 minutes, covering an average distance of a half mile.
As the community dialogue rages on regarding the Arlington High School rebuild, one local group of improvisational players tries to tell the emotional tale on all sides of this hot-button issue.
Oh, this is my science classroom? Oh. Yeah, sure, I mean, the floor is nice and dark and black.
True Story Theater staged a performance at Thompson Elementary School this week to act out the strong feelings of students, teachers, and residents on the redesigning of the beloved but aging Arlington landmark. There were performances about the aesthetic character of the structure, how to improve the educational experience, and what the outcome would be if things like the familiar exterior facade facing Mass Ave was forever lost. Players also staged an interactive QA with audience members to get their take on the issue. The next community forum on updated design concepts and the high school rebuild process is set for November 27th at 7 p.m. at Town Hall. Coming up on the other side of the break, Old Glory currently flies in great numbers at Arlington High School. Why it's so important to honor the heroes past and future, especially this time of the year.
And Arlingtonians have a wonderful opportunity to enjoy the color and pageantry of a choir from half a world away. With such a marvelous sound and an important message for us all. That and more when we come back.
Listen.
All it took was someone who would insist that I just try.
Suddenly everything was turned around because they judge you.
You tell them, I don't need this.
No one is going to understand.
Unless they've been through it, how can they?
Then one day you realize
you feel so hopeless.
I need help. I need help.
You feel so hopeless.
Then one day you realize
unless they've been through it, how can they understand?
I don't need this.
No one's going to judge you.
Suddenly everything was turned around because they insist that I just try.
All it took was someone who would just...
Listen.
Did all the election year banter give you a back or a neck ache? You are not alone.
One area health center is doing something about it. ABC Family Chiro and Wellness sponsored its second Arlington Health Fair on Pleasant Street this week, trying to introduce area residents to the many natural and alternative healers in town. Arlingtonians learn how to take care of themselves naturally and safely, and discuss the positive effects of good nutrition, yoga, acupuncture, and so much more.
So chiropractic is very simple. It's based on that your brain controls your whole body. It does that by sending down signals through your spinal cord, out through the nerves to your body, and then feedback from your body back up to the brain. When that flow of information is without any nerve interference, excellent health is expected.
ABC's fair also covered the lifelong benefits of pure, non-toxic products. There was even a private natural chef on site, cooking up scrumptious and healthy recipes. Bon appetit.
You may have noticed beautiful display of the stars and stripes on the front lawn of the Arlington High School.
At this time of year, when we honor our veterans, these flags represent a very personal thank you to the heroes who positively inspired and enriched the lives of so many people. APN Stephanie Wittenbach was there.
A virtual sea of flags at Arlington High School, each with the name of a loved one on it. These flags are the result of donations to Rotary International. Each banner represents a special hero in the lives of others. Area residents who have made a positive impact in their lives, mentors, teachers, coaches, and military members, just to name a few. These flags will grace the front lawn of the high school for 2 more weeks. And the local Rotary Club pays it forward with money raised.
The proceeds from Flags of Heroes will go towards empowering future leaders thanks to the Rotary Club.
Flags for Heroes provides funding for scholarships. That we provide a $1,000 scholarship for a high school senior from Arlington High, Arlington Catholic, and Minuteman.
Rotary officials say they're helping students of today become the mentors of tomorrow. These flags will remain standing on the grounds of Arlington High School just in time for Veterans Day. For Arlington Public News, I'm Stephanie Wittenbach.
Veterans Day is Sunday, November 11th, marking the 100th anniversary of the end of World War I. There will be a parade at 10:30 a.m. Sunday from Walgreens on Mass Ave to the Central Fire Station. Immediately following the parade, there will be a wreath-laying ceremony at Monument Square.
Sadly, the curtain has now closed on the 2018 Arlington International Film Festival. But critics say it was a blockbuster year for groundbreaking films. And a world-renowned musical group brings its magical sounds to Arlington with a poignant message for all of us to follow and remember. Here's APN Arts and Entertainment reporter Jamie Joseph with a preview.
Another banner year for the Arlington International Film Festival, which took place November 1st through the 4th. I spoke to AIFF founder Alberto Guzman, who said he was very pleased with the overwhelming response he received from moviegoers, sponsors, and volunteers alike. The AIFF featured movies from all over the world, covering a wide range of subjects, from historical documentaries to films on social justice abroad. Guzman said this year's festival attracted a slightly younger audience than in years past, and that many theater seats were filled with film buffs who reside far from the confines of Arlington. Alberto says he's already planning for next year's coming attractions. We'll keep you posted. Meanwhile, we bring to you sounds from magical Soweto and South Africa. Listen to this. This is the color and pageantry of Imolonji Cantu, an award-winning South African choir with deep roots in the past that continues to sing about present-day struggles for freedom and equality. Imolonji Cantu will be performing November 10th at Arlington Town Hall. This one-of-a-kind choir was founded 30 years ago in Soweto. These marvelous entertainers were among the first to publicly express through song the struggles under apartheid in South Africa. Choir leaders say many of these singers witnessed firsthand the horrors and cruelty in the South Africa apartheid years ago. They vowed to lend their voices to let the world know about the atrocities that befell their friends and the unfinished work that remains. Members of Imolonji Cantu were honored to sing at the inauguration of President Nelson Mandela in 1994 and at the enthronement of Nobel Peace Laureate Archbishop Desmond Tutu. After South Africa achieved democratic rule, the choir continued to spread its message of peace and reconciliation and has been an unrelenting messenger of hope throughout the world, and it continues with its 2018 Boston tour. Imolonji's visit to the Bay State is sponsored by the Sharing a New Song Chorus, or SANS, who accompanied Imolonji on its South Africa tour 2012 and 2017. SANS and Arlington Center for the Arts fought hard to bring Imolonji right here to Arlington. Now you have the opportunity to support their concert and workshop at Arlington Town Hall Saturday, November 10th. Those who go will learn songs, dances, and discuss the diverse cultural traditions of South Africa. You can learn more about Imolonji Cantu's visit to Boston and purchase tickets by visiting their website, acarts.org or sanschorus.org. That's it for this week. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Jamie Joseph for Arlington Public News.
Coming up next, Arlington Catholic High's Drama Club stopped by our Studio A earlier this week and gave us a sample of their latest performance gracing the stage at Town Hall.
And the Spy Ponder boys and girls soccer matchups are heating up. That and more when we come back.
You're never too old. Be an organ donor. I had a liver transplant about 6 years ago from a 66-year-old stranger. It is the ultimate gift, I think, because, you know, personally, it saved my life, but it's possible that he saved 7 other lives as well. I'm so thankful for what I've been blessed with as far as receiving that organ, you know, and I can't thank that person enough. Life for me has been great ever since. My wife and I do a lot of things now that we didn't do before. I'm alive today because this older gentleman stepped forward and said yes to organ donation. It's just human nature that people think that they reach a certain age and they say, I'm kind of old, nobody's gonna want my organs. But it's clearly not the truth. It's any age is viable for transplantation. You're never too old. Be an organ donor.
Girls and boys soccer are among the headliners this week at Arlington High School.
Here's Carlos Abreu with our Studio B with all the Spy Ponder action on the field.
Hello, Arlington sports lovers, and welcome to another edition of the ACMi Sports Update. Many of our Spy Ponders are having a winning playoff season this year. Boys soccer continued to move forward in the playoffs after a narrow win against Belmont in penalty kicks. They also played Lynn Classico in the quarterfinals and came away with a 4-0 win.
Ball shoots across. Oh, Francesco, over to...
It slips in the turf. Shot. Have it. Goal! Oh, he finds the back of the net.
Lucas Plotkin, and it looks like the assist.
I think go to Sean Connolly.
Was it Connolly?
Yep, he was the one that made the extra pass.
Yep.
The boys will be playing the semifinals at Manning Field in Lynn on Saturday at 12 p.m. Be sure to check MIAA.net for the matchup. The girls' soccer team also made their way to the quarterfinals after a tremendous 3-1 win against Beverly.
Nice hustle by Maggie O'Sullivan, and she's running at the goal. What's she going to do? She takes a shot. And the goal!
Unfortunately, after a tough fight against Cocker Carlisle, the girls' season came to an end after a narrow 1-0 loss. Girls volleyball moved up to the quarterfinals in their tournament after a 3-0 win against Revere. Unfortunately, their season also came to an end after a loss to North Quincy. After taking some wins on the road, Spy Ponders football made a strong match in Medford last week where they took a 28-35 loss. They'll play Waltham at home on Friday, November 9th at 6 p.m. That's all we have for the sports this week, but be sure to keep tuning in to ACMi for more coverage of your Arlington Spy Ponders.
Of course, we'll have all your Spy Ponder sports action leading up to the Thanksgiving holiday.
And you can check out our latest segments and newscasts on the web at acmi.tv/news. And don't forget to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter at Arlington Public.
If you have any news tips for us here at Arlington Public News, we'd love to hear from you. Email us at news@acmi.tv or stop by the studio at Park Ave. I'm Carla Dorado.
And I'm Paul Whirlin. We leave you tonight with the marvelous sounds of Arlington Catholic's Drama Club. Students gave us a preview of their upcoming performance, The Greatest Show Women.
Showtime is at 7 p.m. at Town Hall, Saturday, November the 17th. Tickets are currently on sale. Enjoy and good night.
See you next time.